Ooh, up to me, huh?
You went with me last time, and I was correct.
Phoenix is not a great hero, though.
He's great in this game.
All right, I'll go with you, Blitz. Ride or die.
Time to be two for two.
Homies forever.
Arkward and Father Tidehunter, Yapzor on Sand King. Down at the bottom, we have Ace Lone Druid. We've seen his Lone Druid a few times. It's very, very impressive. Up top, though, Secret of Hunting. This one's dispelled. They know someone's there. They find the door. They catch him. Mid-Icarus dive. And that, without a doubt, will be your first blood and going to mid one as well. Nice bit of extra gold to kick him off in the mid lane.
That ward did not see them, actually. And Matu's going to get pressured pretty hard by this, though, because there's a Sanking up there, too.
Out comes the courier. Courier's got the ward down.
He's going to get it.
To get it. And that is the courier gone.
One more hit.
Let's get the Wraith Man delivered.
And they're diving on it. Mid one.
Three heroes moving on to mid one.
Uh-oh, mid one. He's dead.
I'll get the courier. I'll get the kill as well. Laser and rocket from Miracles to finish off mid one. Puppy will be fine.
Patience from Kuro.
And Miracles a bit of an awkward position. Mid one's going to TP straight back in.
This is a pretty nice game for Tinker. The one thing is that the Arc Warden also can work in that Factor Versum because of the Spark Wraiths. You can put them all around along the tree lines later on in the game, and you can have that as a scout. But this happening is a big disaster. Arc Warden is one of those heroes that if you actually die too many times early on, it's very, very difficult for you to catch back up because the aggression is just going to keep running at you. So GH is doing a great job of that, and I think we're going to keep seeing that happening for a bit with this Night Stalker Tinker matchup. Versus him.
Secret do finally move the lanes once again, taking Ace down here, yep. Away from the Lifestealer. And Yapzor hunting down Mind Control, see if we can spot him out in the trees. Three has the Icarus dive over mid lane again. This liquid aggression between the three of them coming in mid each and every time. And they're getting kills every time they move in.
Again, Matu instantly switches down toward bottom. He sees the Lone Druid there. He doesn't want to stand 1v1 versus a Tidehunter either, because that's not a great matchup.
Yep, sorry. He's going to miss the forest strike, and Matuma is here, ready to punish him for that misplay. As Matuma Man, as soon as he turns up to the lane, gets himself a kill.
He's probably pretty thankful there. Yapzor almost coming in. He's trying
to go for his bear here. Matuma Man, ready to come in, but Savage Roar forces him back. GH just get the slow with the void, and they should be able to claim this bear hit.
Can he deny it?
That gold. Oh, he gets it! Ace!
Oh,
you're not getting that 300 gold, he says.
They want him now. They're like, you deny it?
He'll summon a new one. And
he's
with
okay.
That, he's fine. Yapzor and Puppy turn up. They're ready to turn this around. Looking towards Kuroki. He's been left behind. Secret jump in. Ace getting the kill as well. Denying that gold from Liquid, drawing them in, and picking up a kill.
When Miracle respawns, they will probably try to go for mid one here. Puppy, though, walking into them. He tanks the gank.
Yapzor's there to try and help out. Little Burrow Strike, and mid one looking to turn. Has the flux onto GH. GH backing up, standing close to Kuro. Wraith's down, blocking off the path. Liquid have to be careful with the retreat. They're not going to get GH out of there. GH goes down. Mind Control's come through. He's bringing mid one down very, very low. He's trying his best to finish off this Arc Warden. Gets another spirit out onto him, and Mind Control will be able to claim the mid one kill. Kuroki's able to deny himself to the Ancient, so Yapzor can't find that. Mind Control picks up a second. He's got a double.
What a rotation.
Can he get more out of this?
He doesn't have any more spirits.
Both of his spells are down for a long time, and Yapzor shining up will live, but indeed, Mind Control turning up like that, getting two kills. Matuma Man and GH have found the bear. Savage Roar from Ace peels them off it. They're still trying to chase it, though. Again with another void, that arcane rune for GH helping them chase down Ace's bear. Mind Control swoops in to surround it, and this time, there won't be a deny. The gold there, believe GH claiming the final touch, 300 gold into his bank.
Potter completely ignored in this game. Sitting top by himself, farming. 300 gold for GH, though. Very nice early on.
Puppy as well. Fada can make a good attempt at Kuro's life. Kuro trying to fly himself away. We'll get over the tree line. And Fada will not quite be able to find him for now. Does have phase boots, so this lane getting even scarier for any members of Liquid to come in. Mid lane, mid one, dove upon. They'll get the kill. Cost them GH's life. Yep, so see if he can chase down Miracle. He does have Burrow Strike back up. Playing around with it for now. And he will not make an attempt. Miracle will be fine. Bottom lane, Mind Control, and Matuma Man also stepping up the aggression. As soon as Liquid go mid, Liquid also make a go down bottom. They're finding the Lone Druid, and they'll take it. Mind Control, with these movements, getting some crucial kills for Liquid.
Yeah, the Core Phoenix, he's turning up every single time. That mid lane rotation was the big one, but now bottom, with Matu being able to pressure the Lone Druid. Ace, really having some trouble here. He doesn't have a resummon for 85 seconds either. So he's going to be just a ranged very weak hero for the next minute or so. Three minuses is then in this game. That's three, I think, a total. Yep. Soon. Lone Druid has one, Arc Warden, and Phoenix will have it. finale one.
I'm gonna find Fada here. He does have the hood, and he has got the shrine by him as well. We'll see if they have the damage to bring him down. It's a bit of a hard hero to go in upon. Ravage comes in into the ice blast, the Pura as well. Oh, that was questionable at the best. Going on the Titan to like that
under a shrine as that, well.
A little ambitious from Liquid, and it hurts them. That's lose both Mind Control and the Timberman for that effort.
That's an extremely costly one too, because it's Ace pushing the mid lane during all that, and that slows down a lot of the momentum, with the Infest being on cooldown now for quite a long time.
Cause both mids at a very similar pace.
GH is scouting out Secret, but he's under vision of a ward he's getting wrapped around on.
And Yapsil's got the connection, comes in with the Burrow Strike, GH punished for this one.
Look at that defensive ward by Secret.
It's going to be interesting to see who becomes the bigger issue this game, the Arc Warden or the Tinker. Both absolute nightmares if they get their items. Mid lane, mid one. Though, gets jumped on. They've got the combo. Matumaman brought in by Mind Control. Ice Blast flies through. Yapsorb will go down as well. Liquid, keep everyone alive. They're going to jump in, look to close the gap. Mid one trying to hold them back, but with two heroes chasing him, he's going to need some backup, and backup is inbound. TP's coming in, he'll drop down the field. Supernova's there on the sidelines, though. Mid one, he will fall. Ice Blast comes in over to Matumaman, but still with the Rage, ready to fight. He's trying for it, but the Ravage comes in. Fada holds him back. And mid one actually claiming the double kill there as the final tick to the flux of the race gets the kill.
Combined on the same team. Scan comes out. It actually does catch Liquid here. They are positioned here for an Infest Bomb. They're going in anyway, though.
They are straight in. Looking for mid one. Mid one gets the field down. They've got the Burrow Strike in the air coming through with the ult. Matumaman rages. He's able to finish out mid one and the Tempest double. Supernova's falling low. Puppy nearly able to claim it, but he can't quite. Mind Control gets the ult off. Raise out onto the Puppy. Pipe comes through from Vada. Is it enough to save Puppy? It is. And Mind Control swoops forward, takes down a second, and now Vada's in trouble. He's surrounded around the tree line. Three members down on Secret. Yapsor tried to jump in, but the silence was still on him, so he couldn't react. Has to back away. Liquid get three.
They're trying to take advantage of the greediness from Secret's lineup. They know there's no Radiant hit on the bear, so Secret taking these head-on engagements is still very, very tough, even though they have the Blink Dagger on Sankey. I think the epicenter was actually cancelled there by Kuroki's Winner's Curse.
That Savage Roar there. Miracle was trying to close in for the last bit of burst to finish the bear and his owner off. That Roar saving his life.
And Radiance is back.
So the man's got his eyes on Yapsil. Goes for a quick sandstorm, but the sentry's down. Ready to chase, ready to burst with the splinters coming in from Kuro.
Top, he's getting chased out here by the Radiance, but he's in a very deep spot. He can't blink.
He didn't expect that Radiance, it's only just come out.
The rest of Liquid, though, coming in for the defense.
I don't know, Miracle can get through this one. Mike Drummond to my man, turn him. Oh, he gets the blink off! Miracle, he's gonna live! He managed to blink out just in time, gets himself out of the range of the Spark Grave, and Secret, they've lost two. They do get the Ice Blast down onto Matumaman, and they get Mind Control. So this time, Secret able to buy back pretty hard. They'll surround Kuro. Kuro, could he get himself out of this? GH trying to get a look in onto Ace, but Kuro in a lot of trouble. Ace brings the bear back through. Kuro trying to fly himself away. Ravage actually comes out from Fada as he looks to lock down the Night Stalker as well, and he does find him. Miracle jumped in desperately, looking to finish off Ace. In fact, they do get him. GH able to get the final void to kill off the lone druid. He'll almost certainly pay with his life if Yapsor and Puppy can find him. He's looking for the Dukes in the trees, still alive for now. But they do spot him out. He silences the Sand King, but with three heroes there, GH will fall as well. So they get the two cores, Liquid. They get both Ace and mid one. Jump on who? Yapsor heading over. Just moving out of the range.
They see mid. They see Ace in the mid lane. They're going in.
They are. They're trying to move in straight away onto mid one. Supernova comes out. Secret having to split, having to back up. Mid one forces himself away. GH finds the range for the void. They'll close the gap onto the arc. One Ravage comes in from Fada though. He's keeping mid one alive. Mid one still trying to back off. And mid one, can he live? No, he can't. GH will be able to chase and finish it off, but they lose Matumaman. Liquid moving in for more though. They've got the numbers. They've taken down three. Only Fada and Yapsor left alive on Secret. Eyes onto Yapsor looking to juke it off with the Sandstorm and Burrow Strike will make it up to the high ground, but GH, Miracle, Mind Control, they're diving into the base. GH, he's got to back off. A little early to dive behind the tier threes, and he will slide himself out of the base. Fada unable to chase him down, but Liquid.
I'm out too.
Here we go, onto the tier two. In the mid lane, onto the side. Yapsor finds the jump Burrow Strike onto GH. Controlling him with the Yules, there's the silence, the damage from mid one and the bear, more than enough. They'll take a kill, Mind Control has the Timberman inside, they'll swoop forward, they have the Supernova, trying to go for this. Can they get the kills out of it? They'll look towards the bear being brought low, not enough to take him down. They'll pop the Aegis once on mid one forced back. He'll be able to get himself away, Fada moving in, doesn't have Ravage though. He won't be able to pop it. Secret keeping everyone alive, they do lose that Aegis, they will be able to blink the bear out in time. That's That's quite some mass. What a close game indeed. Once again, I think people after game one were sort of wondering, are we really going to get more of it? And so far in game two, we certainly are. The skill level.
Miracle's got a very scary rune in his bottle right now on top of that Kaya. He has that arcane.
Oh, that's the dream.
This is really the dream. He's getting very close to that level 25 as well.
See what they can do. Fighter on the front does have Ravage available again.
They've got the darkness.
GH going with the silence. Mind control sweeps forward. They find Puppy. Puppy's down. No AA for this fight. They're trying to move in for more liquid. Mid one's there with the response. They've got the control. The Bloodthorn as well. Down onto GH. There's enough damage with the Spark Grave. GH is down. Matuma Man moving in with the BKB. Going straight for the Arc Warden. Cuts through mid one. He's looking for the Tempest double as well. And he'll get it. Both of Arc Wardens down. And they're
Ace
not even done. They're finding Ace as well. Buyback comes out from mid one. But Matuma Man's already got the triple kill. Mid one has got to be seriously careful about how he reinitiates on this, and indeed he won't. He'll hold back, even with that buyback, he just can't get in there.
Miracles. The team fight's still very scary from Liquid.
And look at mind control.
Yep.
They may be ready to go for some sort of sneaky play. Secret know this though. They're smoking up, they're trying to move in from the sidelines. Mind control will reveal himself with the sunray. Move down to the low ground. They'll find Kuro first. Moving in straight away to the Wyvern. Ice Blast comes in. Mind control and Matuma jump through. And instantly they take down the AA. Matuma Man and GH surrounding Yapzor. Yapzor gets the blink off in time off the back of the Yules. He's getting out of there. Miracle looking to chase. The mini stun of the rocket, slowing him down a little bit. Jump forward again with Miracle, but the sandstorm from Yapzor jukes out the rocket. He continues to go down with a burrow strike. Miracle finds the burst. He gets the range, takes him out. They'll find the Tempest double as well for sure.
They needed that buyback from Miracle. They don't want to give up that Roche by any means, and now they can try to make their way back.
Gonna try for the bear here. At least GA's leading in. The rest of the team coming through. Mid one will TP onto the bear here. He's gonna try and send in his Tempest double to do some damage. Bring him down low. With Yapzor jumping in with a burrow strike. Ice Blaster passed over. GH will pop. Secret get one, and they're looking for more. Fada jumps forward, he has the Ravage to catch our Miracle. As you say, he's got the Aegis. The question is if they can bring him down twice. Supernova coming through. They're trying to put a stop to Secret, but Secret, they'll be down on the sun. Can they take it out in time? They can't. They'll put the Refresher, but the Supernova Stone catches them all. Ravage comes in from Fada. They've caught Miracle again. Miracle in a lot of trouble. Winter's Curse for Kuroki. He's trying to buy space for Miracle to get out. It's enough. Miracle's able to blink himself away. Midborn gets in. He finds the Bloodthorn. Jump forward. Yapzor gets the two-man burrow strike. Miracle's down. Kuro silence. Up as well with the Bloodthorn. The BKB out as Matuma Man is trying his best to redeem this fight, but Liquid, they've lost three and Matuma Man surrounded as well. Yapzor again, another burrow strike holding down the Lifestealer. They'll beat into him and Matuma Man slowly but surely should fall. He's getting the cheese back into his inventory. He does have the cheese. He's trying to turn towards Yapzor, but Yapzor slides himself away. Mind control comes back in. Matuma Man is actually going to survive it all. The cheese is enough along with the heart.
Wow.
To keep that man alive, but still Liquid. Pretty ridiculous how beefy that man is. Mid lane, coming in to put a stop to this. Oh, they get the silence, they get the burrow strike onto the Phoenix. Oh, the Ravage as well! Phoenix is down, he has to buy back straight away. Butter moving into the base. Matuma Man turns his attention towards him. Winter's Curse holds back. Mid one, he's getting beat into by his own teammates. Will he go down the Splinter's Blast? Is it enough? He forces away the pipe. It will save him. Mid one will live. Matuma Man with the BKB moving forward, trying to chase down this Tide. But Tide, Butter gets the blink off in time. The Bear's going to be the new target to focus on the back lines of it all. Yapzor gets the, he gets the ultimate. It's enough to bring down the Tinka. Tinka down for 100. But they're still backing off. Secret have to be careful. The Bear will go down. Matuma Man gets the kill.
For the other day, just be able to go for that rat, and nighttime is kicked in. Now it looks like this will be when Liquid goes for a fight, but they still have lane issues, and Secret also brings this rush down so damn fast. It is already dead.
Refresher shot, ready for whoever wants to take it.
Probably Fada. Yeah, triple Ravage.
So. Get it over on that man.
Puppy passes it off to him.
There we go. Triple Ravage at the ready. Actually finding the GH Nightstalker out. Oh, Mind Control comes in with a save. Picks up GH immediately. Matuma Man with the Rage trying to move forward. Miracle jumps in. Burst down mid one once. That's the Aegis is gone. Refresher pop by Mind Control. He's ready for another Supernova. Coming in, cutting them off. Up for the high ground. The Ravage from Fada comes through. That's the first one. He's low on mana. Has to back away. Winter's Curse from Kuroki. Locking down mid one. His own team pick him out. Secret have lost two. And Liquid are ready to chase for more. The bots coming in on top of GH. They've got their eyes on Fada. He does still have the pipe. Miracle looking for the Yapzor Sand King instead. Yapzor slides down to the low ground, able to get the blink off. But two heroes down.
They didn't commit the second egg either.
They didn't. Mind Control's got that ready for the push. And they may have a good chance of forcing out the buyback from mid one arc one. And he's down for 90 seconds.
GH with his DD, he's soloing the Roche as a Night Stalker support.
Secret are on their way over.
Yep.
Can Liquid take it down in time? It should be fine. Ice Blast coming through. Still heading in. We're not going to see GH head up, sort of try and block this one off. They're back off as the Ice Blast does connect. Being
the
careful how
in.
They commit.
Arcordon's keeping in too.
Oh, the push is the Miracle deal with both of these. That's the question. He's got the Hex onto both. He's trying his best to deal with this split. They may find the bear. BKB's popped. The bear's still alive. He's going back up the racks, but he will get taken down. Oh, that supernova just in time as Mind Control nearly falls to the control of the Tempest double. Back it towards to the pit. Fada's got his eyes on GH. Kuroki and Matuma Man still outside the side of it. Fada moves him with the Hex, drops it down onto GH. Secret going into the pit. Matuma Man pops the Rage, moving on to Fada. Fada pops the BKB. GH and Matuma trying to take down Fada. Do they have the damage? Liquid, they need backup and they need an out, but look at the base. They've got the split push again. The bear has been TP'd in. Liquid, they're having to deal with this Roche fight and the base. Oh my goodness. The base looking to be in a lot of trouble as well. They do manage to force it back out, back towards the pit. GH has been caught out, blown up by the Ice Blast. No Night Stalker for 100 seconds. Secret, they'll claim Roshan. Liquid just getting pulled apart as there is so much for them to deal with. And now the Wyvern's in trouble. Mind Control comes in with a Supernova save, dodging the Ravage for both of them.
Instant Refresher Shard used by the Lone Druid so we can actually have a bear since that second one did die in the mid lane.
They're trying to retreat. Secret looking to chase. They've found Kuro. They should be able to find him. Hex, Nullifier, the Silence from the Bloodthorn as well. They've taken down two. Liquid, no buyback on GH or Kuroki. Can Liquid really hold 3 against 5?
Wait, no, sorry. He popped his Refresher Orb. Apologies.
Boss comes in. Gonna pass over Matuma Man. Rage is popped. They look towards Yapto. Fada pops the Ravage, but Matuma Man still with the Rage, trying to fight. Look towards the Tempest double, but Miracle's been jumped on. He's down for 100. Buyback from him. Buyback from Mind Control. They're trying their best to hold. Matuma Man popped the BKB, but the racks are already down. Secret got what they came for. Can Liquid punish them? They'll try and push back Matuma with a Savage Roar. Matuma Man cannot chase Secret out of this. Yapsil comes back in, looking for the bonus right. There's the second Ravage. He's caught Miracle. This is going to be a dieback on Tinker. He's down for 2 minutes. Secret slowly but surely just breaking down Liquid in this game. And GG will be called. Secret take game two as they lead this best of five grand finals 2-0. What a mentally draining game that must be for Liquid.
Out of my mouth right there. They were looking at a pretty good position when they forced a lot of buybacks there, going for the pushes, but Ace with the Lone Druid, Arc Warden as well for mid one. Just the constant seed.